Hello, Mr. Calvo. We are so glad to have you here in Belgrade, in Serbia, in our newsroom Objective. Thanks for coming.
Thank you very much to you, and thank you for welcoming me here in Belgrade.
And of course, the biggest subject in the world of football now is the European Super League for the rich, if I can say it like that. What is Roma's stand on that subject? We know you had a statement yesterday, but can you tell us a little more about that now, especially because Florentino Perez yesterday said that like they were talking to Roma and Roma is like considering to join.
No, our position has been very clear and has been summarized in the statement that we made yesterday, that we truly believe in an inclusive football through the current institutions of football. So we believe in the merit of the sporting performance. So our statement was very clear and speak for itself on the position of Roma, with no room for misinterpretation on that.
Yes, Serbians, a lot of Serbians like Roma and they cheer for Roma. You have a big fan base here. I don't know if you knew it. And we had a lot of players there: Siniša Mihajlović, Adem Ljajić, Aleksandar Kolarov, even some guy Nemanja Radonjić. And do you remember any of them? Did any of them leave the mark on your footballing eyes?
Yes, of course, you mentioned very famous footballers that played in Italy, not all of them for Roma, but some of them for Roma. And the last one is Kolarov, which I know him personally because he's been in Roma until last August. And he always proved to be a super professional. So I think there is a strong connection between Italy and Serbia and between Italian football and Serbian football.
Is it true that you will offer Aleksandar Kolarov some function in the club in the end of his career? Because there were some reports about that.
No, that's, to be honest, is the first time I hear that. He's a friend of the club, so the future, you can never predict what the future will look like. But he's happily playing at the moment, so his career is definitely not over.
Yeah,
and is about to win a title, most probably,
yes,
in Italy.
Yes, yes. Italians haven't played Europa League with so much passion in the sum of the last years and decade, for example, because there were not so much money in the Europa League as in the Champions League. But now UEFA have started giving more money to the Europa League, and you are now in the semi-final. How is this competition? How much does this competition matter to Roma in this moment?
Europa League is, I find it in a very difficult competition because you play against clubs that maybe are less well known than others, but it's very difficult. You play on a Thursday night and then you have the domestic league on a Sunday, which makes it very, very difficult. And yes, Italian clubs, they didn't perform too well until a few years ago. Then I remember Juventus reached the semi-final, I think it was in 2013, might have been. Inter Milan reached the final last year. Roma is now in the semi-final. So this proves the Italian clubs are understanding the value of Europa League and are trying to fight hard. Not always you can be successful, but at least we always try. And for Roma, this year is extremely important. We had a season with up and downs, and now we're toward the final of the season, and we are in the semi-final of the Europa League. And we really did the objective of every football club, of every owner of a football club, and of every player, and of every fan, is to lift a trophy. And so we hope we will get this chance to go to the end.
You play with Manchester United. They had a really, really tough period because now there are reports from England that their president or the second man of the club is resigning after this season because of the whole Super League thing. Do you follow what's going on in Manchester, and do you think you can beat them now?
Yes, we've been following, but I believe that players, when they go on the pitch, all they focus about is the performance on the pitch and to win the match. So it will be a very tough match because Manchester United has a long winning tradition, so that means they have a winning mentality. They have unbelievable players. So it will be a tough semi-final, but we'll fight as well.
Did you hear about some theories that this Super League is just way of UEFA to make way for the new Champions League, because now the people see Super League and they are like, wow, man, this is very bad. And now they just give the idea about new Champions League, and it feels like better than Super League, you know. And before Super League, people wouldn't be so much into the new Champions League format. Do you think maybe?
No, I don't think that's the case. I think UEFA has been working for the past 3 years to reform or to develop the Champions League, the current Champions League, and UEFA did this with all the possible stakeholders of the world of football, from European League Association to National Association to European Club Associations, meaning with all the clubs. So the reform of the Champions League approved on Monday was worked on with all the stakeholders of the world of football. So I believe it will be a successful one, and is the right way to develop the world of football, of European football.
You are originally from Torino, you worked at Juventus, you work at Barcelona, now you work at Roma. Even Milan wanted to get you when you were at Barca, if I'm not mistaken. Can you make some connections or differences between those three very, very big clubs, large clubs?
Well, yeah, I have the privilege that I've been so lucky to work now almost for 10 years in the football environment, and I entered by chance in the world of football. Then wasn't my ambition really, because I never thought of working in football, even if I worked in sport all my life long. And at the beginning I thought I would have stayed in one football club only, and then I would have done something else. And then the passion that you put in your work and the football is able to transmit you and made it possible that now I'm been working for 10 years in three different clubs, very different clubs. I say the leading Italian club, one of the biggest clubs in the world, and then the Roma, which is kind of a different club because of the connection with the city, because of the passion. And each of them is very different. But I would say it's an unbelievable adventure for me still going on.
And because you worked at Barcelona, and you probably know what happened with EuroLeague in basketball and FIBA, do you think maybe if Super League has happened, as it isn't for now, but if Super League has happened, could UEFA and FIFA suffer the same fate of FIBA? Because the EuroLeague is the private competition, and the Super League would also be the private competition. And it all happened in Barcelona in those years.
I'd say impossible to predict, because the breakaway of EuroLeague happened almost 20 years ago, now they started. And the governance of basketball was at that time very different from the governance of football nowadays. And we've seen the pressure that came up from fans and from governments and from all the stakeholders of the world of football in the past 48 hours. So I think it's very difficult to compare the two scenarios, the two cases.
You came, if I'm not mistaken, when James Palota was the president of Roma.
Yes.
And now it's Dan Friedkin. What has changed?
Mr. Friedkin, the new ownership group, is coming with a lot of enthusiasm, and they're trying to transmit this. A very ambitious ownership. They've been investing a lot of money in the club, and they made it clear since day one that they are investors for the long term. And we've seen yesterday in the statement that for them, the passion of the fans and the integrity of the sport is more important than the money. And I believe they are making our fans very proud. As always, let's say, the process is difficult, and the sporting performance is what matters to the fans the most. They arrived when the season was already started, so that we are having a challenging first year for them. But I can assure, I've seen them every day in the offices, at the training ground, the passion that they are showing, the respect for the game, and the ambition that they have is, if I would be a fan of Roma, I would be extremely optimistic.
And do you think maybe now is the time to expect the return of the Principe di Roma, the Francesco Totti? Can you tell us, is Francesco Totti in plans for some future, near future?
No, Francesco. For sure, Francesco will always be part of the family of Roma, because let's say he's been born at the club basically, and he spent 30 years at the club. So the club will always be his home. His son is playing for our youth sector, and Francesco comes to the to the our facilities often. So he's part of the family. He decided to take another entrepreneurial path, and we don't know what future will reserve us, but I would say that the doors in both sides are always open. It's just a matter of him also seeing if he likes what he's doing now or not, and if there is opportunity for him to add value at the club, which is what I believe if he would join the club he would like to do, to add value to the club.
And you say you said that the fans are enthusiastic, and can you tell us, do you expect in years that are coming the attack on Scudetto?
So that's the ambition of every player and of every president of a football club, is the one to win, always. Let's say for us, now the biggest priority with fans is to be able to welcome them back at the stadium, because football without fans is not the same, and we know how much our players, they miss the support of the fans, and how our fans, they miss seeing their heroes in live. So, as I said, the ownership is extremely ambitious, so I cannot wait for them to experience a match with the fans and to really feel with their hands what the passion for the club is, and I believe this will be like gasoline for them, new fuel, in order to be even more ambitious than what they are. Then winning is, there is always at the end of the season one winning the Scudetto in that case, but what is important is to fight for it.
One more business football question. Juventus made the new logo, Inter also did it. Is there any possible chance of Roma going in that trend, or do you stick with your traditional emblem?
But at the moment, let's say they did for, I would say, business reasons or marketing reasons, and we already had a change of logo 5 years ago that had created some controversy among our fans. So our intention is to stick with traditions and really to listen to our fans first.
Yeah, and we talked about Serbian players, and I know that you are not a football person, you are a business person in football, but are there some talks maybe inside the club, inside the club government, about some Serbian players maybe coming there next season, maybe somebody from our league, because we do a lot of business with Italian league, especially Red Star and Partizan and Čukarički from a couple of years ago.
When there is a transfer market, I'm always the last one to know things, and I'm very happy about that, because it means when everything goes leaks to newspapers, I'm not the one responsible. So on this case, I'm like a fan, and I wait to receive news from the newspapers, because it doesn't affect my daily business. But I do hope, let's say, that we have always looked for the best players, and we know that in Serbia there are a lot of extremely good players, so we don't have any preclusion for that.
Thank you very much for your interview. And now just one more question for our neighbors from Bosnia and Herzegovina. They would like to know about this very much. Edin Džeko and coach Fonseca have some problem, and there are a lot of reports about it. Where is that gone wrong, and why Džeko doesn't play Serie A? He plays only in Europa League.
No, I think that in every family there are moments of tensions. This is normal, and really we are a family to Edin and Džeko, and he feels at home with the club. So now all the problems are over. He's playing very committed, and we just seen last Thursday against Ajax the match that he played, and his commitment for the club and his happiness when he scored the goal. So the problems are definitely over, and we can't wait to get to the end of the season at least with him in a successful way, on the pitch successfully, I mean.
Thank you very much, and I wish you all the luck in this season and in all next seasons that are coming.
Thank you very much, much appreciated. And thank you to you for your time. Thank you.